with my own two hands make a better place. With my own two hands make a kinder place. Oh, with my own two hands. With my own, oh, with my own two hands. With my own two hands. I can make a peace on earth.
There's a paradox at the heart of beautiful metalwork, which is that metal is something that we think of as being incredibly strong and functional. I mean, we use it in buildings, we use it in furniture, but most of our metalwork nowadays is purely functional. It's all about right angles and straight lines. And that's fine if you're building a building, but if you want to make something beautiful, you've got to put natural flow and natural lines into it. And the paradox for me that I explore in doing metalwork is making something rigid, fluid. And the way that you do that is that there's no greater designer than nature itself. So a lot of the stuff that I do will be kind of based upon flames or flowing hair or plants or leaves or flowers and stuff like that. And if you can capture that, which is a very, very difficult thing to do, but when you do capture that with something as rigid and as hard as steel, there's something about it which makes people's imagination come alive. And that's the challenge of doing blacksmithing for me, is capturing something fluid and impermanent and making it permanent with steel. That's the challenge. It's a massive frustration sometimes, but when it works, it feels fantastic.
Now I can hold you in my own two hands, and I can comfort you with my own two hands, but you got to use your own two hands. Use your own two hands.
Generally, I mean, there are more and more people learning about blacksmithing because they realise that it's a craft that's dying. But the one thing that's lacking is the education that people need, that it's a very, very slow process. You know, it takes a long time to make a work of art. You know, like that fire basket that I've made took me about 2 weeks to make. So the price that you've got charged to cover your time has to reflect that. And there aren't many people that are prepared to pay it. So that's the problem, is that really you're kind of competing with mass-produced rubbish from China. But mass-produced rubbish from China doesn't have any of the grace or quality or flow that good artistic blacksmithing has. My forge is called the Thirsty Bear Forge. You know, because I'm a bit of a bear and I've got cubs to feed, and I'll get thirsty when I'm hammering away on the metal. So you just need to go to thirstybearforge.co.uk and you can see what I'm working on at the moment, and that's how you get in touch.
Use your own, use your own, use your own, use your own.